Alright guys, what is up? It is me, Mr. Z, and I am back with another RTS video. In this video, I am doing another tier list. I figured it was a pretty decent time ago. I'd say it was like 2 months ago since I made my other one. And since then, Limit Break 2 has come out, and a whole new trial has come out. So why don't we just jump right into this, shall we? So, first off, Conrad. He is a pay-to-play character and is a new addition to the list. And I think he's actually very good. He gives 30% attack to all teammates, and three teammates get a Guardian Shield. And his passives are, you know, it's supposed to counter tanks by giving minus 40% attack to a random tank if there is one on the enemy team. Which isn't bad, but Ezekiel kind of counters him the first few turns. But is still very good, especially against offensive teams. You don't need to bring Mirabelle if you don't want to. He's a very solid leader, and I do think he deserves an S. Elodie is pure dumpster fire. Don't use her. Don't invest. Wayland is still good with it. His limit break 2, it wasn't really that bad, but it was, you know, could have been better. He's still good, and I still use him on every single team I do. Yes, because he can hold a strong attacks weapon, and I do use some strong characters on my teams, so he deserves an S. Same goes with Zachary. We all know him. We absolutely hate him, and there's many reasons why, from his bleed to his annoying passives. There's nothing bad about Zachary. Deserves an S. And I'm also going through these characters really quickly, especially if they are already ranked on the list. I'm unsure if Harper was on the last list, but she basically gives 25% attack and 25% trait advantage damage. So stacking strong characters behind her is very good. And I honestly think she deserves an A tier. She could be, you know, S to B. I don't have her, so I haven't really tried her, so I'm gonna give her an A for now. We'll see if this changes once everyone can get her. Thomas is still bad. Rosita, she's just not good. You can use her on Conquest, but there's a better character if you want control. Carl, still dumpster fire. And Andrea. So this, I am surprised she is a free-to-play character. She is really, really good. The burn damage she grants, and you know, she gives she gives a lot of burn damage. She also gives crosshairs, if I'm not mistaken, on her passive, and she can't get reflected. Or I mean, she can, but she has a chance of reducing it to zero. She's really good. I'm putting her in the S tier. I am really surprised that she's a free-to-play character right now. If you can get her to limit break 2, definitely go for it. Michonne 2000. She's the definition of a absolute nuke. 1000 damage in total. Rampage on a strong character. And revive. Yeah, I don't see how you can have problems with her if you have her. She really is a hurricane of death when she pops her AR. Yeah, she's really good. Yes. Kapoor is good. It's unfortunate that his attack is really high for a defense character, but that's just logic, I guess. He has to have high attack because he deals a lot of damage based on his max HP. He's good, has good passives, and I really do think once everyone can get him in Limit Break 2, he could, you know, have way more potential than he is at Limit Break 1. But I'm gonna put him in the A. This may change, of course. But yeah, he deserves an A. Jessie is okay. She doesn't really get that much of a buff on Limit Break 2, but she's okay. Dr. Stevens, I'm gonna give him top of A. I don't think he has S tier potential, just because if you just ignore him, he doesn't do much. He has heals, He's superior to Jesse. He's probably one of the best healers in the game. And the Halo is also good. Decap counters him. And there is a little bit of decap in the game right now, which is nice. Just because there's a lot of crosshairs going around right now, I think I'm gonna give him an A. He's still good, and I really wish I had him in tier 5 at least. Jesus, meh, he's bad. There's a better character. Gov is still S. Nothing changed really. He got more. I think he deals like more bleed damage with his new break too. I don't really care. His rush is what makes him good. Just one-shotting two people. Cliff, I think Cliff is really good. Considering, he tanks a lot and his passives are good. And there's really nothing bad about him. If he had more control, I would have given him an S. But I don't think he's just quite there to make it to S. So I'm gonna give him an A. Gregory is bad. Don't use him. Lori 2000, there's been some arguments going around that she could be used, but the only issue is she's supposed to counter Governor, but like, do you really want to spend one slot on your team just to counter Gov when Zachary is a bigger threat? You know where I'm coming from? I don't think she had does enough for your team that she can actually be in the top tier on this list. So for now, she's gonna sit on C. I like her neutralize. I think that's the best part, but she's a bit of a disappointing character. Connor got probably the best limit break to out of everyone. I'm actually gonna give him even better ranking than Bichon 2000. His passive now is on turn one, and it taunts two people for two turns. That is very insane, considering he can lock someone if they get taunted to him. And if his passive is proc, you can pretty much taunt lock someone. Ashe, she's not good. Her active skill deals a little bit of damage, and her rush also deals damage. But there's better characters. I wouldn't use her. Negan, he has some very, very, very good potential now. He might even be a good defense leader now because of Connor and Mirabelle. If Connor and Mirabelle didn't get those turn one actives, I would have given him an A. But just because now you can get taunted or confused, the taunt counteracts that, even though it can get removed later, but it really is useful. Definitely use him if you have him. I'm giving him an S. Herschel is bad. Don't use him. Lori Grimes. I think Lori Grimes paired. I'm ranking her solo. And standalone, she's kind of an executioner. It's even her specialist skill. But she doesn't really. I don't think she's good enough to make it to the top as a standalone character. If she's in a full alert team with Carol, then she's good. Then I would give it an A. But we're ranking this solo. So Beta F, not good. Rick, don't use him. I think I put Rick like B to C. No, don't even use him. There's no reason to use him whatsoever. Ah, this guy. If you got all the characters from Skybound 2000 or Skybound X, you're lucky. You are a very lucky individual because he is ultra broken. That's all I'm gonna say. I think he really is broken. There's nothing bad about him. His weapon is stupidly good. I don't know why he has so much defense on his base weapon, and you can make it go further. That's the thing. Like, it goes so far on his stats, and his stats are also good. They're defensive, and their attack isn't high. So he's gonna be actually immortal. He's gonna be immortal. I've said it before. I think he's immortal, and he's probably gonna be the best character in the whole game. Just because of his command, and he's really gonna be in the game for a very, very long time. It's maybe gonna take years for him to be replaced as a top tier command, so I'm giving him an S. How many pluses? Like, actually, I don't think it's enough pluses, so there we go. Glenn, I recommend staying away from him. He gives you AP when critting, but that's pretty much it. I don't think it's really that useful. Frost is bad. Princess is okay. I gave her an S last time, and now I regret it because Andrea 2000 is just a better princess. So, if you have her, congrats. And if you don't have Andrea 2000, definitely use Princess, but Andrea 2000 is just better. Ivanova deserves an S. She's really good. She got a very, very good buff on Limit Break 2, the crit damage multiplier on her passive, and her Adrenaline Rush dealing, like, I think it's 100% more. So it is a ton of damage, and considering she was good before this, and she's even better now, you know, why would I not put her in the S tier? Eren is just a tank. He doesn't do much other than just standing there. He can revive, but it's just not good enough to, you know, put him in a better tier. Also, how did I put 21 in here? Ah, whatever. Gator, I think this is good. His defense can go up to like 60,000. So I think he deserves a B tier, because he could be used on defense. I'm actually using him on defense because I don't have a replacement. But he's okay. Mercer, I mean, it's the weak version of Connor, let's be honest. I wouldn't use him. Andrea, I'm sorry, but you're going in the A tier as well. The reason being that I'm moving her down from the S tier is because she doesn't really deal enough damage to, you know, get her follow-up to proc. If you can make the follow-up proc, she's really, really good. But it's not really consistent. She's a better defense character these days on just offensive defense leaders, so I'm gonna give her an A. Tyrese, I said he was disappointing before. He still is. I wish he was better, but he isn't. Shiva isn't good. I wish he was, but she isn't. Martinez is interesting. I think he has potential. He's definitely a decent controller. I really like the passive. Confounding is really, 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 really good. But, you know, I can't really fit him in on my teams. And on defense, I think he's just going to get one shot. And, you know, he's kind of a window compared to some other controller that I'm going to talk about later. That's, you know, so could be used on offense. But, yeah, I'm giving him a B tier. Harlan is bad. Cal, I'm going to give him an F. I was considering putting him in the D tier, but why use Cal when you can use Mirabel? And this guy costed money as well. Sam and Tom, I think Sam and Tom has potential. Not that other people have Sam and Tom because, you know, he's a promo. But there's also, you know, if you have him in Limit Break 2, he's very, very good. I'm gonna put him, I guess it's them, in the top of A, just because I can't really say how good they are, because I haven't tested them out. But I think, you know, the passives on Sam and Tom is really, really good. 100% AP if someone dies with a debilitating status, I'm pretty sure. And the days on the active skill and the AR impairing people. Not a lot of people used impair, so resist. So yeah, I'm gonna give them top of A. Barker. So Barker, it's a problem with Barker. So when I got Javier back in the S-class era, I was really stoked because I had a full team of greens and blues. But the only issue with having blue and green on defense is that there's no fast healing. How are you gonna sustain is the issue. Yes, it's the tankiest lead in the game, and yes, he has good passives, and there's nothing bad about Barker as a solo character. But he's gonna struggle as a leader if you don't have fast healing on the team. And that is my issue, and is why I'm gonna put Ezekiel before him. So he has potential. If there comes out a really good green slash blue healer, maybe he can swap around. So that's why I'm doing this tier list more often. But I'm actually just gonna do this right now. Ezekiel, I think Ezekiel is just gonna be better. Also, I think defense team has to have a what do you call it? I think you have to have defense down resistance, because otherwise you kind of just get power bombed by defense down characters, and defense down characters are very good. So that's why I think Ezekiel is just better. He can also hold a what do you call it? A fast healing weapon, which is the best for defense. It's just the best for defense. Sandy, she used to be so good. I think she has fallen off a bit, which is unfortunate. Maybe with Barker coming into the game, she could be more useful on a whole alert and on the all alert team. But I don't see it. So I'm gonna give her a name. Dale is just meh. I put him in like the C tier, that's an insult. He's just not good. Tai is the best defense leader in the game at the moment. The burn is annoying, and if you stack, Marge behind him, and why not Mackenzie? It's really hard to deal with. It's almost kind of impossible to counteract it. I know it is counterable, but it is hard to deal with him if you don't have the characters for it. So I'm giving him an S. It's also still a very good attack leader, so. Erica, double revive. I think she has kind of just fallen off. I haven't really had much use of her. I wish she was more useful than she is, but she isn't. So I'm giving her I'm gonna give her a top of D, because she's not bad, because she has useful. She is useful with the revive and the retribution, but I'm giving her a D for now. Aiko is just eh. She's just meh. She's not an F tier character, because you can still use her on as a leader if you have her, but the issue you're gonna face is the only issue, or I'm gonna say the issue with Aiko is that there's just better characters. Like, why would I use Aiko when I could use Negan, right? So I'm giving her a C tier. Darius F. Dwight has completely fallen off. Why use Dwight when you can use Andrew 2000? I'm giving him an F. Mirabelle with Connor got the best limit breaks too. I'm putting her in the S tier. She's really good. Guardian shields everywhere. Confuse, turn one. Very good. And she fits into almost every single team. Yumiko, no reason to use her other than Conquest, but I think there's a better Conquest character here that's coming up later. Oh, okay. Carol, so. Wait, I'm gonna get an opinion real quick. Wait, I'll be right back.
It would have been even easier than
Yo,
before.
Dan.
Yeah.
You're on video. I need opinion on Carol real quick.
What, Carol?
Yeah.
Yeah, she's OP.
Yeah, thank you. Bye bye. Yeah, no, you heard the man. Like, she is OP. The reason why she's OP is because of her passive, the 80% cleanse. She's the only character in the game that can cleanse Zacary out of mythic characters 100%. It's not 100%, but the 80% procs a lot. So, and her passives are good. Her active skill is good. Her rush is good. There's nothing bad about Carol. I'm almost used. And also, she terminates S classes on defense. You're making a mistake by having Scotsman and pretty much anyone that's an S class on your team right now, because everyone can get Carol. Don't sleep on her, guys. I told you guys last time, I put her like in the top of A. Right now, I'm gonna give her an S. She has proven that to me the last couple of weeks. And if you're not using her, I recommend picking her up. Uncle Sam, I'm giving him an S, of course. He got buffed further with Limit Break 2, giving minus 40 attack, which is super annoying. He was annoying before Limit Break 2, now he's even more annoying. So, he deserves an S. Alice, just useful for conquest. I'm giving her a D. Don't use her on attack, just better attack leader alternatives. Definitely don't use her on defense. Magna, why use Magna when you can use Ezekiel? Or if not, just Barker. Actually, I'm gonna give her an F, because we can't even get her anywhere. So, you can get her out of prestige, but that's it. I don't recommend using her on defense. Skins is really good. He's the first combat medic in the game, which is, by the way, a very, very powerful specialist skill. Critting gives everyone his, like, I think his amount of damage he deals in bonus damage, so he can't be used on defense, really. At least it's really hard to use him on defense, because if you make him too defensively, he's not gonna heal with combat medic. And if you make him too offensive, he's just gonna get one-tapped, so... But I think he deserves an S. He's really a top-tier character if you have him. Not a lot of people have skins, so... Abe... You know, he's useful with Ty and with Andrea 2000. But the thing is, why would I use Abraham when I can use... you know, Andrea 2000? I know he doubles burn damage. But, it's just hard to fit them both in the same team because it takes up so many slots. But he has potential, so I'm gonna give him an A for now. Negan 2000, I underestimated this guy. I think I put him like in the A to B tier last time, which is an insult. I didn't read his passives all that much, and the fact that he can gain Halo if you rush him. He has to use his payback to be useful, but then otherwise you have to just auto him with manual auto if you want to take him out, which slows down time. And at the end of the day, slowing down time on a defense team, then he's doing his job. I think he deserves an S. Michonne, still good. I'm gonna give her an S. She got buffed with Limit Break 2. It was actually a pretty decent buff, giving more damage on the... I think it's more bleed damage on the passive, as well as extra crit damage. I'm not sure if they're bleeding or if they're healing over time, but either way, she's really good. I'm giving her an S. Dexter, F. Gabriel, F. Not useful. Morgan. I think, you know, he's almost on every single defense team, or for the most part, he's on every single defense team. I think he's good. That's pretty much it. He has good buy 2. He's the only character in the game that has normalized resistance. So he's already prepared for that, so... I'm giving him an A, so... Almost done. So, Razo is the superior Rosita, and this is just how you design a annoying character with Limit Break 2. He also got a really good Limit Break 2, by the way. He stuns every turn. There's no cooldown. Or I don't think it's a cooldown. Maybe I'm mistaken, but I think he has an initial cooldown, and then he can start stunning every single turn. He's gonna be annoying to deal with, I think. I'm giving him an S, because I think he actually deserves it with his control. He's probably the best control tune in the game. Sophia is a failure for being a control character. So, Rosita, the anniversary event character. She's good, that's what I'm gonna say. But I don't think she's better than Wayland. What makes her good is her damage, as well as the fact that she, you know, she can hold a 8% weapon. That's the good parts. But the thing is, I don't think I can really replace Waylon on my teams for Zeta at the moment. Maybe there will be some tough meta, then she will be useful. But for now, I don't think she hits the mark as high as Waylon does. But I'm giving her on top of A tier for now. Garrett is bad. Gov 2000 is okay. He could have been better. You're supposed to use him as a leader with other Skybound X characters, but there's just better leaders than him. That's the issue. Maybe I'm gonna be wrong, and everyone's gonna use like Skybound 2000 characters, or Skybound X characters. Sorry, but for now I don't see the potential with him. Can maybe make an all alert team with him, with Carol and Lori and Sandy maybe, but for now I'm giving him a C tier. Alpha, she's good for conquest, that's it. She's probably the best conquest character. I'm giving her a C tier. Don't use her on defense, I'd avoid it. And I think that's pretty much it about her. She's just okay. She's not bad. She has her usages, but yeah, I'm giving her a C. Bruce, I'm putting him in the F tier. I don't see the bleed being enough, you know, to make up for what he does. It's bleeding. He has roll. I think it's what does he have again? I'm pretty sure it's on a roll he has. His passives are decent, but it's just not enough. And that was pretty much it. That was kind of a quick one. So, if there's anything here that you disagree with, feel free to let me know why down in the comments below. This has been Mr. C, and I am out. Have a good day, everyone. Bye-bye.